Monster Laboratory here. Today we're going to take a look at a force sensor that you can connect to your Arduino. I bought this one off of Amazon. These sensors are excellent at detecting force or pressure on a surface. They're not so good at detecting actual weight. These sensors come in a variety of shapes and sizes. You can get them with short leads, long leads. They come in a circle shape. They come in square shape, which is what we have here. And they come in strips. The square is probably the least accurate of them all, but it does a really good job at sensing pressure or force and a change in pressure on a surface. You may notice right away that these have male solder tab connectors at the ends of the leads. I didn't want to be restricted to just plugging them into a breadboard, so I wanted to put some female connectors on it. That didn't work out so well for me. For whatever reason, I couldn't get them to stay on, so I ended up soldering some extra long wire onto the leads. If you choose to do this, be careful, you can melt that plastic on the sensor, and then your sensor's done. I know this isn't the prettiest soldering job, but I didn't want to go back and fix it because I could already see the plastic starting to warp. To make sure that the connection didn't break, I got some rigid clear plastic, I put some hot glue on it, and I glued the leads right onto that hard plastic so that the leads couldn't bend and eventually break. There are other options for pin connectors for this sensor, but I think this will work just fine. For this video, I'll be using a force sensor, 4 5mm LEDs with 220 ohm resistors, some male-to-male jumper wires, and 2 male-to-female jumper wires, an Elegoo Mega microcontroller, and in our voltage divider, we'll be using 3 different size resistors. This is a 10K, a 2K, and a 100K resistor, just to show you a little demo with the sensor. Now's a good time to go to the datasheet because it does give you all the information you need to know. This is a very popular brand, Interlink Electronics. My sensor can operate in a range of 1 ounce to 22 pounds. Beyond that, it's unreliable and you can damage the sensor. It is flexible and made of multiple flexible layers. Let's scroll down to the bottom of the datasheet here and take an expanded view of those layers. Here are the dimensions of the square sensor, and my sensor is roughly 1¾ inch by 1¾ inch. Scroll down here a little bit, we see there's an adhesive layer, a top substrate, a spacer adhesive, and a bottom substrate, and those are the 4 layers that make up this sensor. Like I said before, this is a variable resistor, and once pressure is applied to these flexible layers, the resistive carbon elements will touch conductive traces, which reduces the resistance. These LEDs give a good visual of what's going on. As force increases, the resistance will decrease, and the voltage will increase. You can see here as I add more and more force to the force sensor, the LEDs will continue to light up as the voltage output increases to 5 volts. Here is a quick sketch of the setup that I have, if that helps you. Here you'll notice that I've circled the voltage divider circuit, and I've even labeled the pull-down resistor just for reference. If you go back to the datasheet, you can see the equation that gives you the relationship between resistance and voltage in our voltage divider. That's V out is going to be your voltage out. RM is going to be your pull down resistor. For us today, it would be either 2, 10, or 100K. Your V is your V source. For us, it would be 5 volts. And then your RFSR is your resistance of the force sensor. If we go back to the data sheet and we scroll down a little bit, we can see the circuit for the voltage divider. You'll see that it says FSR with a squiggly line and an arrow through it. That is the variable resistor. That is the force sensor itself. And you'll see RM, that is your pull down resistor down below, and when voltage is measured, it's measured across the RM or the pull down resistor, not the FSR. The 2 graphs that you see are just for general understanding of what's going on. They're not 100% accurate. On the left, you see that as force increases, resistance decreases, and at first you see a sharp drop in resistance, and then it goes into more of a smooth slope. The graph on the right is a force versus voltage graph, and it shows that when the pull-down resistor is high, like 100K ohm, it takes very little force to produce a voltage output of 5 volts. And when the pull-down resistor is very low, like 3K ohm, it takes a lot of force to produce very little voltage output. You can see that a 10K ohm pull-down resistor is a happy medium right there in the middle, as it initially spikes to right around 2 volts with very little pressure, and then it takes more and more pressure to get to 5 volts. Let's take a look at this circuit in real time with a 10K ohm resistor. I open my serial monitor so that you can see the values in real time, and as I press on this, you can see that within 0.8 ounces the first light comes on. The three LEDs come on under a pound, and it takes about 4 pounds for that fourth LED light to come on. And that's using a 10k ohm resistor as your pull down. The next resistor I'm going to use is a 2k ohm resistor. I don't have a 3, but by looking at the graph, we know that it's going to take a lot of force to get that voltage output to increase. So now I have a 2k ohm resistor as my pull down, and you can see initially that the first LED comes on at 0.8 ounces, and then now the third one's on under 2 pounds, and then it's going to take a lot of pressure for that fourth one to come on. But as you can see, I come up to 21 pounds and it still hasn't lit up. Next, we're going to use a 100k ohm pull down resistor, and from the looks of this graph, it looks like it's going to take very little force to increase the voltage output. Well, I have my 100,000 ohm resistor in place, and as you can see, at 0.2 ounces, the first light lit up, the third light lit up within 3 ounces, and they all four light up under a pound. So very little pressure, and voltage output increases very quickly. Here's a quick look at the code. It's very simple. We have our sensor pin set at analog 0. We define our four LEDs and the pins that they are on, and we set those LEDs as outputs, those pins as outputs. And you'll see down here in the loop, these numbers, these are just, I picked them arbitrarily. These numbers appear as values in your serial monitor. As force increases, those numbers go up. And I set it so that as force increases, the number of LEDs that are lit up increases. So if all four LEDs are lit up, that means that there's a lot of force being applied and the voltage output is very high. You can find this code posted on the channel Facebook page. If you want to buy this sensor, I'll leave a link in the description below. Also, if you want to check out the datasheet for yourself, download it. I'll leave a link to that as well in the description. That's all I have for today. Thank you very much for watching. I do appreciate it. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to like it by giving it a thumbs up. Also, if you haven't done so yet, be sure to follow the channel, click the bell notification button, and I'll see you again very soon.